What's up, V-Stars? It's Vinay, your life and dating coach. Hey, thanks for everyone who filled out the survey. 100 of you guys will be receiving a special postcard in the mail. Today's episode, we're going to talk about getting comfortable in a relationship. So there's two types of comfortables. The first one is, I feel really comfortable around you. And the second one is, you're getting really comfortable in this relationship. And this episode is talking about the second one, getting too comfortable in a relationship. When you're hitting a plateau in the relationship, what can you do about this? This is what we're going to talk about today. Let's do this! You know what I'm talking about when you're in a relationship and it seems like it's been on cruise mode? Like, where's the effort? Either your boyfriend or girlfriend has been putting in effort, or maybe it's you're the one and you've just been feeling, you know, a relaxed mode. This is how we're going to change that and spice up your relationship so that you can have sparks in your relationships again. Most of these tips can go for both men and women, but remember, pay close attention to these tips for you. Guys out there, you know that we women are verbal creatures. We like to hear compliments. We like to hear things. Sure, you probably did a really good job of showing it, but sometimes as females, it's hard for us to interpret what you're doing equals how you're feeling and what you feel for us. Remember to compliment your girls. Even if it's simple, you look great, you know? Oh, I love that dress on you. I love your hair, that sort of thing. Because you know what? We will put time to look good, not only for ourselves, but for our partners. So it'd be nice to be recognized. Physical touch, very important. Very small, light. And you may not think it's a big deal, but it totally is. You know, whether it be affectionate, holding hands, or putting your hand behind her back, or like hugging her, a lot of physical contact. That's what we like, okay? And that shows that you are still attracted to us and that you love spending time with us and that you want to feel that connection. Okay, be romantic, surprises. And it doesn't even have to be something that's really expensive. Even if you like pick a flower from the garden, surprise her. If you write her a note, if you do just simple little things that surprises, make her feel that you're still trying, you're putting in effort, and that you really care about the relationship, you care about her. And she'll definitely appreciate that, okay? The main thing for females is that we love to feel reassured. We love to feel special and valued and appreciated. So the main thing here is appreciation and compliments. To my lady V-stars out there, a lot of guys tell me, and they complain that the one thing about the relationship is sometimes their girlfriend gets really comfortable, and she doesn't even try to, like, dress up and look how cute she did in the beginning of the relationship. That means not only am I suggesting you to, like, you know, hey, looking all sexy and shit, you know, not just for your boyfriend, but for yourself as well. And make your boyfriend feel really attracted to you. And of course, you know, we like to plan and we're like complimenting and stuff like that. But don't forget to do that for your boyfriend as well, you know. Plan things. Go out, you know. Don't stay home and, like, stay in and, like, watch a movie. Though sometimes that's kind of nice, too. But switch it up and go out and be social. Have occasion to put on those freaking heels and that sexy dress. So the key thing is here, don't take each other for granted, okay? When you go into cruise mode and you hit a plateau and you're not trying anymore, that's when the relationship might go on a downhill, okay? So you want to keep it exciting, you want to keep it attractive, you want to keep it hot. So remember to compliment each other, appreciate each other, get dolled up, go out, be social, interact with a lot of friends, and have that balance of being a homebody but also going out as well. And have a good time because, you know, that's where your bond started in the relationship. You were attracted to that person. You had a lot of fun. You had good conversation. So remember to keep at it. You know, don't let the relationship go in cruise mode. I want to know what tips you have for making the relationship exciting again. Okay, I want you guys to leave it as a comment below. And Austin, Chris, and I are going to present to you a brand new spanking, fantastic, fantabulous Vinay.com website. So we're going to be releasing it in January 2011. Got a lot of exciting things coming up in 2011. I'm going to be launching a program to help those who are overcoming a breakup right now, empowering you into warriors. So I'm going to be releasing that program in 2011. Also, my book, Fuck Her, Fuck Him, has been in the works and been working really hard on it. It will be released in the beginning of 2011. And thank you for everyone who's been very patient with it because, you know what, all the hard work, it's going to pay off. It's going to be fantastic and you're going to love it. So if you guys want to pre-order the book, I'm going to leave the link below. And as always, those who want one-on-one coaching or want an online dating makeup profile makeover, contact me, vinea.com/contact. And I hope to talk to you guys soon. Till the next episode.